with Cristiana Santos. And this is Women's Month, and we are so excited because there are so many talented women and so many talented young women, and I'm honored to be here today with one of them. Mrs. Northeast is her title, as well as outstanding student and just all around terrific young lady. So Cristiana, tell me about your title.
So I never did pageants or anything like that before, and one day my mom was like, do you want to try a pageant? And I was like, okay. So we did some research, and my mom herself was involved in the Kodo pageant industry when she was a young teen adult, and she was so happy that like the industry was still alive and like going. So she signed me up, and we talked to the owner, and she was so excited that I was actually joining. And so on December 3rd, 2017 was the actual pageant, and I went, I gave it my all, and I won, and it was just a really good and fun time, and I was really happy I did.
Awesome.
It was kind of a little bit of everything. I did a talent portion, I did one of my older tap routines that I learned from my studio that I'm currently at, and then I had to do some headshots and send them in as well, and they kind of just asked me some questions up there, got to know me a little bit better, and it was kind of an all-around pageant.
And then they fell in love with you.
Yeah.
So tell me about school, because I know that you're a super student also. So tell me what you're involved with in your academic and your extracurricular activities, and where you go to school.
I go to school at Woodland Regional High School. I'm a senior this year. I've been a part of the Best Buddies program. I did a lot of one-on-one peer mentoring. I met a lot of new people. The kids are so, so sweet. Every single day in school, I get a new hug, a high five. It's just, they're amazing. And I was asked to be a part of National Honor Society my junior year. I'm still a part of it today. And I've been a part of the dance team for 3 years, so that's really helped me as well as to gain better leadership and more friends and things like that.
So. Good. And so what are your plans in the fall?
This fall I plan on going to Sacred Heart University.
Oh, you got in?
Yes.
Excellent. Congratulations. That's always a hard, stressful time waiting to get into colleges.
And there I'm planning on pursuing a career in the health science field. And that was mainly because a few years ago, I lost one of my best friends to cancer, so being by his side, it really helped me learn more that I love to help people in times that they're kind of too vulnerable to help themselves. So that's something I really grasped onto, and because of him, he's the one that really pushed me towards that profession. So
you're just as beautiful on the inside as you are on the outside. So this is Women's Month, as we talked about a little bit. Tell me who inspires you the most.
I think one of the most inspiring people besides like my mom is definitely my grandma. I love my grandma so much. She's adorable. I think just from, you know, she came from Portugal with her family when she was younger, and she's definitely, you know, strived to put herself out there in America, tries her hardest to understand English still to this day, tries her hardest to speak it sometimes, and she's just always there for me, and she's such a sweet lady, and every time I'm out in public with her, especially around like the Portuguese community, everyone's like, oh my god, it's Irene, like we love her. So she's definitely one of the women I look up to.
Oh, that's wonderful. And everybody too.
Yes.
Obviously, everybody loves Grandma Irene.
Yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful.